Hello, my friends. I'm so happy to see you. Welcome to our new EHBC Kids Sunday Night online format. I'm Miss Elise, and I will be sharing some Bible lessons just for our littlest lambs. And then Pastor Joe will come and teach the older kids as they continue with their series, Doughnuts. I am so excited to learn about how much God loves us with our first study called The Adventures of Moses. We are going to learn about some of Moses' big adventures, starting with the very first day that he was born. And we'll see how even though Moses got a little bit scared sometimes, nothing is impossible with God. Let's listen to our memory verse first. I can do all this by the power of Christ. He gives me strength. Philippians 4:13. Pretty cool, huh? I'm going to say it again, but this time I'm going to use motions to help me remember it. You guys try it too. Just follow along. I can do all this by the power of Christ. He gives me strength. Philippians 4:13. Good job. Let's try it one more time with the motions. And then I want to hear you yell it loud. I can do all this by the power of Christ. He gives me strength. Philippians 4:13. Guys, that was really, really loud. Great job, everyone. Keep practicing that all week long because we'll do it again next Sunday. Are you guys ready to hear our Bible story? Let's get our Bibles out. Everybody show me your Bible. Hold it up really, really high as you can. The Bible is God's word to us, so we know that everything that it says is true. Ask for help and turn your Bible to Exodus chapter 2, verses 1 through 10, because that's where our story is. A long, long time ago, a bad pharaoh in Egypt made a law that said no more baby boys could be born. Do you guys know what a pharaoh is? A pharaoh is what a king in Egypt is called. And they were the boss of everybody. So when they made a law, everyone had to do what the pharaoh said. Moses was born right after the bad pharaoh made this evil law. But his mommy loved God and knew that God would help her and her baby boy. So she hid Moses so that the evil Pharaoh wouldn't find him. Moses' mommy put the baby boy inside a basket and put the basket in the Nile River. Moses' big sister Miriam watched the basket to make sure it was safe as it floated in the water. Soon, Pharaoh's daughter came out to the river to bathe. She saw that basket and got it out of the water. Do you think she was surprised to see a baby when she opened it up? Yes, she was. She was very surprised. But Pharaoh's daughter decided to take care of that baby boy so that Pharaoh couldn't hurt him. Moses was safe. Moses was just a baby and needed help to stay alive. His mommy helped him by keeping him hidden. His sister Miriam helped him by watching over him. Pharaoh's daughter helped him by taking care of him. And above everyone else, God helped Moses too. Guess what? God can help you too. When you need help, you can turn to God because nothing is impossible with God. God can help you no matter what. Okay, my friends, let's use our big brains and remember what we learned today. Who hid Moses in the basket so the bad Pharaoh wouldn't find him? Do you remember? Good job. His mommy, that's right. Mommies do take very good care of us, don't they? So who watched that basket while it floated in the river? Think. That's right. Moses' big sister, Miriam, watched over him. Do you have a big sister or a big brother who helps you keep you safe too? Last, who took Moses out of the basket and decided to take care of him? Think hard. That's right. It was Pharaoh's daughter that kept himself safe from Pharaoh. But who was keeping everybody safe and helps keep you safe too? God. God can help you and me no matter what, because nothing is impossible with God. Let's put our hands together and pray. Dear God, thank you that you always keep me safe. Nothing is impossible with you. Please be with me when I need your help. Amen. Thank you, my friends, for listening to our story tonight. I hope you can come next Sunday too. And always remember how much God loves you and that I love you too. We're going to let Pastor Joe talk about donuts now. I wonder what he's going to talk about tonight. Let's find out.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Miss Elise. That was a great study. Good evening, everyone, you guys. I'm Pastor Joe Vivian, and tonight we continue with our Bible study, Donuts. doing right was never so sweet. What a great evening this is going to be, you guys. So don't forget, we've got to always remember this, you guys. God gave us 10 commandments to help us live a life that's sweeter, not only to Him, but to everyone around us. Kids, remember this, please. The 10 commandments can make us and the world around us a sweeter place when we know them and understand them and make them a point of focus for our lives. So tonight's study is titled, pretty cool, huh? Donut Sunday. That's exactly what it's titled, Donut Sunday. But before we get started, I want us to continue learning this study's key verse, okay? We need to learn this study's key verse. So we're going to put this right up, okay? You guys ready? It's Joshua 1:8. Okay, Joshua 1:8. Now, we've been going through this. This is our fifth week in donuts. So hopefully you guys have started to learn this and start to apply this. So let's do this together. You guys ready? This will be the key verse, okay? So here it is. Let's read it together. Okay, we're going to read this together. Joshua 1:8. Never stop reading this book of the law, okay? This book of the law. Never stop reading this book of the law. Day and night, you must think about what it says. Make sure you do everything written in it, okay? Then things will go well with you and you'll have great success. Joshua 1:8. Okay, I want to stop there real quick on this, okay? Just because I read this front to back doesn't mean that I'm going to have great success and everything's going to come to me. Did you notice the key thing in there? It says, you must think about it and do what it says, okay? Make sure you do everything written down in it. Why I'm saying this, you guys, is why that's important is Jesus even said, if you love me, you will obey my commands. We've been talking about the commandments. We're going to be talking about the fourth commandment going into here, okay? And it's so important that we understand something, that we have to obey God's word. Okay, I want you guys to think about this week. What would happen in your household if you obeyed your parents the first time? The first time they asked you to do something, you obeyed them. Think about that. What would it be like in your house? Okay, just something to think about. I know right now you're like, wow. So let's go over the verse again, you guys. I'm going to put it up big screen for you guys to look over it. Okay, let's say this one more time, big screen. Never stop reading this book of the law. Day and night. You must think about what it says. Make sure you do everything written in it. Then things will go well with you and you'll have great success. Joshua 1:8. Great. Now, remember the question I asked you? And now looking at Joshua 1:8, will you have great success and a great relationship with your parents if you obeyed them the first time every time? Now you guys getting an idea of what Joshua 1:8 is? Same thing with your relationship with God. So great. So let's also not forget this, you guys. We've been saying this all during the study. And this is what I call our tagline. It's something to remember. Doing right was never so sweet. Doing right was never so sweet. That's why we call it donuts. Donuts are pretty sweet. That's what we need to keep remembering throughout this study, you guys. Tonight's lesson is called Donut Sunday. Okay? My hope is that after tonight's lesson, each of you will learn the fourth commandment. Okay, the fourth commandment. So I need you to get your Bibles, okay? Get God's Word. Get your Bibles out, you guys, and open them up to Genesis chapter 2. And we're going to be in verses 1 through 3. The title of this, God Rested, okay? So I have mine ready to go. Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 and 3, okay? So as you are turning to Genesis 2, okay, I want you to know that God wanted His people, Israel, to live as sweet a life as possible, so He gave them the Ten Commandments for being sweet to Him and sweet to others. Again, remember what we said? Doing right was never so sweet. But before we get started, while you guys are turning there and you get to Genesis 2, you know what? We're going to do another fun quiz, you guys. We always have some fun quizzes. So let's test our knowledge. We're going to play the quiz called Creation. Kind of ties in what we're talking about today. So we're going to play the quiz called Creation. Are you guys ready? Are you ready for it? Now let's see if Pastor Joe can get past 100 points. I don't know about you guys, but I'm trying. Exactly. We're crossing our fingers. We're like, okay, help him. So let's do this. You guys ready? 1, 2, 3, let's go.
Welcome to Bible Trivia. This time we'll be asking questions about creation. The first question for 100 points. How many days did it take God to create the universe according to the book of Genesis? Was it A, 1 day, B, 6 days, C, 7 days, or D, 100 days. The answer is B. It took God 6 days to create the universe according to the book of Genesis. The next creation question for 200 points. What did God create on the first day? Was it A, light, B, air, C, sun, moon, and stars, or D, water? The correct answer is A. On the first day, God created light. The next question for 300 points. What covered the earth? Was it A, plants, B, animals, C, the ocean, or D, bubbles? The correct answer is C. The ocean covered the earth. The next question, this one is for 4,001 point. What did God create on the seventh day? Was it A, a man, B, a woman, C, water, or D, nothing, God rested? The answer is D. On the seventh day, God created nothing. God rested. The next question for 0 points. What shape did the earth have? A, it had no shape. B, it was square. C, it was round. Or D, a triangle. The answer is A. The earth had no shape. The next question for lots of points. What did God say to create light? Is it A, bring on the sunshine? B, here comes the sun? C, let there be light? Or D, cease darkness? The answer is C. To create light, God said, let there be light. The next question for 700 points. What else was created on the day that man was created? Was it A, birds, B, sea life, C, land animals, or D, plants? The answer is C. On the day man was created, land animals were also created. The next question for 10,000 points. What day did God say was very good? Was it A, the first, B, the fourth, C, the fifth, or D, the sixth? The answer is D. God said the sixth day was very good. The next question for 5.5 points. Which day of creation was all plant life created? Was it A, the first day, B, the third day, C, the fifth day, or D, the second day? The answer is B. All plant life was created on the third day. Now for the last question, worth 1,000 points. What did God give man to eat? Was it A, animals and plants? B, plants and fruit? C, fish and plants? Or D, animals and fish? The answer is B. God gave man plants and fruit to eat. Thanks for playing Bible Trivia. We hope you'll play again soon.
Hey, how'd you all do? You know, I think I did better than last week. I think I got close to 100 points. I got 95 points, I think. So, yeah, hey, I'm getting there. I'm working my way up. So let's get started on tonight's study. Now remember, I said you should be at Genesis chapter 2. We're going to be reading verses 1 through 3, okay? Yeah, that's where you should be. Awesome. So here we go, you guys. Now, I want you to think about this. How many of you are at church or in this COVID time watch church every Sunday? How many of you do that? Go to church or watch it online? Maybe not every Sunday, but almost every Sunday, right? Okay. Now, everyone answer this question for me, okay? How many of you would make an extra effort to be at church or watch it online if you knew that that particular Sunday was Donut Sunday? Or get this, or that Pastor Joe would deliver a dozen donuts to your house if you watched Sunday morning service online? How many of you would get up to do that? If you knew there were free donuts waiting for you, how many of you would jump on mom and dad's bed, get everyone dressed, and even warm up the car for your parents just to get to church? Or make sure everyone was up and ready to watch it online. You had the TV up, you had it going. You know, donuts are a great motivator for Sunday mornings, aren't they? Donuts would be a good motivator really for any day, in my opinion. So I bet those of you who would have trouble getting out of bed in the morning for school would have less trouble if you had donuts waiting for you, right? It's just a shame that people don't get just as excited about Sundays without donuts, though. You know, I want you to think about this, you guys. Sunday is supposed to be a special day. It's the day we come together with the family of God to worship the Lord, whether in person or together as a family watching online. We are blessed to live in a country where we have the freedom to worship God however we choose. We are free to express our Christian faith openly without fear. But for so many people, getting up on Sunday is a chore. It's something we have to do, and not something we really want to do. God tells us in the fourth commandment to honor the Sabbath, the day of rest set aside for worshiping Him. Now, God created the Sabbath when He created the world. And the Sabbath is to be a day of rest, of refreshment, and worship for our God. So follow along with me as I read Genesis chapter 2, verses 1 through 3. So the heavens and the earth, are you guys there? I just assumed you were. Okay, good. Let's start. Chapter 2, verse 1. It says, so the heavens and the earth and everything in them were completed. On the seventh day, God had completed His work that He had done, and He rested on the seventh day from all His work that He had done. Verse 3. God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy, for on it He rested from all His work of creation. Now, for 5 days every week, we work, don't we? Okay? You go to school, your parents work, we work now, okay? Like I said, adults go to their jobs, and kids now do the school thing. We've just started the new school year, whether you're home online or you're in person, but we're doing the school thing. When home, we do homework and housework, okay? We have 5 days to learn, to earn money, and to do the work necessary in our daily lives. The Bible tells us that God created work, but it also tells us that God created rest. Did you guys catch that? Right here. God blessed the seventh day and declared it holy, for on it He rested from all His work of creation. He created rest. God wanted us to set aside 1 day a week to refresh ourselves, to rest and worship Him in such a way and reflect on Him. Not get caught up on everything else, but to rest in Him. Just as God took a break after creating the world, He wants us to take a break, to pause, to have an intermission, to put a break, to reflect on all we have done, and to worship the Lord because it's all about Him. It's not about us. Sunday should be a day of rejuvenation. Do you guys know what I mean by that? A day of getting strong again in Him and allowing His love to overflow in us. It's a day to recommit ourselves to God before we start the new week. It's a day to count our blessings and to fill our hearts with joy as we praise Jesus. Sunday is a holy day, and God has commanded us to keep it that way. I want to land this plane right now. I want to drive this home. Okay? Follow with me, guys. In biblical times, the Sabbath was actually on Saturdays, okay? The seventh day of the week, in biblical times. The Jews took the Sabbath so seriously, they told the people they could do no physical work at all that day. Businesses had to close, okay, on that Sabbath day. No one could work the fields or do any other kind of labor. Meals had to be prepared on Friday for Saturday because you couldn't cook on Saturdays because that was their Sabbath, okay? Some people even put a limit on the number of steps they took during the day. Now, but today, you guys, I want you to understand, Sunday is our Sabbath day. Sunday is our Sabbath day. The Christian church chose to make Sunday the Sabbath because that was the day Jesus rose from the grave. We don't have all the laws and restrictions the Jews did, but God still wants us to make Sunday a day to rest from our work and worship the Lord. I know it isn't easy getting up early on a Sunday and getting ready for church, and I know it's tempting to use Sunday as another day to sleep in and not get up and watch it online. And you want to make it a day, but you know what? But when we come to church, whether in person or online, ready to meet the Lord, you guys, and praise and worship Him, we will come away more refreshed than if we had taken a nap or slept in. God fills us with His Holy Spirit, and when we come together and praise Him, it's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful time of spiritual rest. We can receive blessings from the Lord in church that will renew our strength and prepare us for the week to come. I wish that every Sunday could be Donut Sunday. I really do. Not because people come for donuts, but because, guess what? I told you, I love donuts myself. But even without the donuts, Sunday morning should be a sweet time of worship and fellowship. Sunday is a special day to come together with our brothers and sisters in Christ. Sunday is to rest, to worship, and to enjoy the blessings of God. So let's honor the Sabbath like God has commanded us. Let's make Sunday morning a priority. I guarantee you, and I promise you guys, you'll be amazed how restful and renewing Sundays can be when you commit to keeping it holy and worshiping God. And finally, let's never forget who our Sabbath rest truly is. You guys realize our true Sabbath rest is in Christ Jesus and no one else. In fact, for some of you, this might be an opportunity. You might not understand and have a relationship with Jesus Christ, but now's the time. Now's the time to surrender your life, turn your life over to Him, and start this new rest that you've never experienced before. That's when the Sabbath begins. Is your rest, your relationship, your time with Jesus Christ. So if you haven't, I encourage you right now to surrender your life, turn your life over to Jesus Christ. Say, Jesus, I want you to be the boss of my life. I ask for forgiveness of my selfishness, my sins. And I want to turn from them and I want to turn to you and follow you. I want to obey your word. I want those blessings by following you and knowing that you will renew and refresh me. Starting this day forward. If that's your prayer and that's your commitment, that's all it takes is saying, Jesus, I surrender my life to you. If you've done that tonight and this is the first time you've done that, email me at joe@ehbc.org. I want to know about it. I want to hear about it. I want to be able to pray with you and celebrate with you. And maybe some of you are so busy, you're neglecting the rest. Rest in Jesus Christ. Find that time to rest in Him. Put a pause on life. Make an intermission. Take a break and find time to rest in Him. Will you guys pray with me? Heavenly Father, Father God, I thank you for this time. You are an amazing, amazing God. And we thank you for this opportunity. You taught us rest. You displayed rest. Lord, let us not neglect that. Let us not forget about that. But instead, find a time to rest in you. To focus in on all the blessings you have given us and showered upon us. And Lord God, for those listening today that have not surrendered their life, have not turned their life over to you, Lord, let this be a time that they experience this special rest for the first time. They enter into your son's Sabbath. So Lord God, I lift up this time and I thank you and I praise you. May we always rest in you. In your son's beautiful name of Jesus Christ, we pray these things. Amen. Amen, you guys. So, I almost fell over. That's not good. Hey, so great study tonight. Great, great study, you guys. Thanks so much, kids, for joining us. I truly appreciate you guys. We're going to continue our donut studies. And for you little ones, we're continuing our Moses study. How cool is that? Okay? So we're going to take time next Sunday. We'll be in our second segment of Moses, the life of Moses. And we're going to study then the fifth commandment in our study in donuts. Okay? So it's going to be important that you guys join us again. Bring everyone alongside as a family. And parents, I am so thankful for you. Because parents, just to put it simply, you guys, you are the donut gatekeepers. Let me just call you that, okay? Because you guys can get us donuts, but you can also cut us off from the donuts, can't you? So God wants us to honor and obey you, parents, as you teach us how to follow Jesus Christ. So parents, we thank you and we love you guys. Kids, please remember also that you are loved and being prayed for. Please don't ever forget that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Now have a blessed and wonderful start to your school year. I hope it's been a great week and a half. Have a blessed week and we'll see you soon. God bless you guys. Love you guys. Bye-bye.